Well, hello and welcome to Cimbrer Bushcraft. Today I'm in Royal Forest, in a beech forest. You can see there's a lot of light in here, so it's a little bit different than the places I used to go to, the dark forest in the pine and the spruce forest. But it's very nice to be out here, and I got some stuff I would like to show you, and a subject I would like to talk about. That's why this video is called Viking or Not. It's regarding Vikings and my videos and subjects that are related to that issue. So I hope you enjoy and hope you hang on. And again, one of my wonderful subscribers has sent me these things. You can see here a nameplate or a copper plate with my name, Cimbrer Bushcraft, and Viking Heritage. And it's located on my rucksack from Frost River. It looks very old school and very cool. And beside that, I got this little sharpening stone. It's an, he says it's an water of air stone, and I looked it up, and it was a place in Scotland where they harvest these stones for shaping, for sharpening all kind of tools, and the factory actually existed from 1415 to 1977, and they don't produce these stones anymore, and it's a great collector's object, and I'm very grateful that Mark Fox from Victoria, Australia, sent me these things. He know I like old school things, and particularly things that are rare to find. So thank you very much, Mark. I really appreciate that. It took a while because he sent me a package for some months ago and haven't got that, so he made me a new one, a new plate with my name in. Yeah, thank you very much. Before I'll talk about the Viking stuff, I would like to make a cup of coffee. It's very nice out here today. It's about 2 degrees Celsius, but there's no wind, so there's not particularly cold out here. But a good nice cup of coffee with a special, you know, will suit me very nice. Yeah, and today I won't make my fire in a bush box stove. Or otherwise, I'm going to use my little stove from Optimus. The Optimus Sphere 123R. Yeah, some of you have seen this before, but I would like to tell you a little bit about it. It's an old type of stove that is made in Sweden, I think. And yeah, Sweden. Sphere 123, it's called. It's a very old concept, and I like using it. It's a white gas pressure stove, and that means that I put some petrol down here, and then I light it up. I show you a little bit later. I prime it first, and then it will burn. And the good thing about this stove is that the pressure down in the canister, the stove is making it itself. I have a Petromax lantern that is also a pressure white gas lantern, and you have to pump it all the time to keep the pressure up in the chamber here down. And that's very annoying because you have to do that every 20 minutes or else the fire will go out. But this one is doing it itself, and I think that is very cool. First of all, I would like to see if there's enough fuel in here. I can see, and I made this. It's a flask, you can see, but I made it look like this so I can see that this is not something I have to drink. I can't drink. It is something that is dangerous, and I have to be careful. I just pour it down here, and be careful not to fill it too much because there has to be some space down there for the pressure, if you understand that. And then I have this one. I just take some up and pour it down here. Yep, and then screw this on again, and then with a match I will light it. So now it is, I think it's called priming. It is warming up, and I can put this on again like this. Yeah, and there's a little key here. And with this is hot enough, I just turn this and the gas will come up here and I'll hate my fire. The only thing about this is it's a bit noisy. It's making a loud sound. So I've seen on the internet that I can get a silencer for this, and I'm trying to find one that is not very expensive and try it out. Now you can see it's burning now down, and in a few seconds I could turn it on and then it will ignite the gas. Yeah. And if it doesn't do that by itself, I just have to light it with a match. There you are. You can hear it making a little bit noise, but that's okay. And then my kettle. This kettle is very popular. There has been some time, I don't know at the moment if you can buy this, but I bought this at Raymer's webshop. It's a kettle that is from a company called Eagle Products. It's a Norwegian brand, and I think it's very cool little kettle. And then we have to find some water. And then put it over the fire. And it is very fast, this stove. It will make it boil very quickly. So now it's time for putting my coffee in. And my salts.
going to have my special whiskey with cinnamon in. Also again from a friendly subscriber that sent me this. And it's very good in the coffee. I like it very much. Skål, everyone. It tastes like Christmas. And it's hot. Did you notice I got a new pipe? This is actually a clay pipe. And I got it from a man in Germany called Markus Fohr. He sells a lot of pipe, and including all kind of clay pipes. And it was my old friend, brother Shem, from PNW Bushcraft that showed some pictures where he had bought some pipes from that man. And I got a few too. You can see on this picture I have some traditional clay pipes that I'm going to use on my Viking adventures. This one is also old school, but more suitable for this kind of trips I'm making here. And actually, I bought this one too. Yeah, it's not a clay pipe, it's a maskum. And it's from a guy in Turkey called Mustafa. And both Mustafa and Markus, yeah, I put links in my video description. You can find those websites. Markus is on Instagram. I find him there. And this guy, Mustafa, I found him on Etsy. So go in and check them out. These two pipes are very much alike. I like this style. Clay pipe and maskum, yeah. And this little foldable tray I bought from PNW Bushcraft. And it's very nice for my pipes, so they don't get wet here in the ground. It's canvas, and inside there's a leather. So this will keep my stuff dry. So especially this pipe, I don't think this is good when it's damp or wet. I think it will soak the dampness. So good solution. Yeah, and you all notice that my style is going more and more in the direction of the Viking style. I like that very much. It's old school and it's a part of my heritage. But I get a lot of questions about my videos and my Viking style, and there's some question I would like to answer now, not directly, but a general, tell you a little bit about my way and my thoughts about making these videos. First of all, I say I'm not an expert, not an expert at all. I read a lot of about Viking Age and the Northmen, and I make my videos out for that knowledge I have there. You can say that I'm using a term called reenactment. I'm going out in the forest and having my gear on, my Viking gear, and trying to make food out there and other stuff. And my goal is to try the material they had in the Viking Age and be true to that, only use linen and wool and wood and iron, and making my gear out of these materials. So no cotton and other modern materials I'll use to try it out. And I would say the wool has surprised me very much. When I'm having my wool tunic on, I can be out in about freezing point and not freeze at all. That's amazing. This cotton jackets are nice to have on too, but it's not so warm as the wool. So, and of course many of you know that. So I'm trying to live a little bit like the Vikings did. Go out in the nature and perhaps make it, it's like if I'm going from one point to another and have to stay there, make some food, have something to drink, and then move on again. And even though I'm trying to only use the materials from the Viking Age, I also have my coffee. They didn't have coffee then, and I smoke my pipe. They didn't smoke tobacco at that time, so it's not role play as that. I'm still Tom from Cimbrer Bushcraft. I'm trying to have a cozy time out in the forest. Just a theme I would like to try out, and many of you are very interested in that, so I hope you'll find my coming up videos also interesting. Yeah, many of you know about the Vikings and how it all came. But I got a question this morning from a guy who's asking me, the Viking, was that the people or a group of people that were doing something special? And it's a very interesting question. The Viking was not particularly the people who are living in Scandinavia. It was the men that took out and made raids, and probably also the trades. The people that lived in Scandinavia is called the Norsemen or Norse people. And a funny story is that in Russia it was called the Rus, the Rus. It was again meaning the people from the north. And that's actually why it's called Russia today. And the town Kiev is actually founded by Vikings, probably Swedish Vikings. The Swedish Vikings make the journey down on the river to Constantinople. The Norwegian Vikings made journeys to Ireland and Iceland and Greenland. And the Danish Viking was mostly in England and France in Europe. So it's not completely in that way, but general speaking about the Viking, it's it was like that they were living. And actually I prefer the term Norseman, because it's more what I'm going to do with my videos. I'm not a warrior, I'm not going out and making raids and bringing home trolls or something like that. I'm just an ordinary person who is living the life that it did in the Viking Age, besides going out on boats and making trips down in Europe. So, and of course the big reason why I'm making these videos, because it's a part of my heritage, my culture, and this is actually a very interesting subject, because the stereotypes of the Viking that are in movies nowadays is not the one that I would like to portray. The Vikings were also people who were living, they were often living isolated and along the coast, and most of the food they get from fishing. And because they were so isolated, they have to be very social, because they have to take care of each one so that the little society could exist, and they helped each other. So it was not a warrior people that was fighting all the time. It was actually very social, and they took care of all of the old people and the people that were sick. And I think that is a beautiful picture of the Norsemen and the Vikings. And another picture than they are telling in stories on TV and films, movies on the theater. So I hope you understand that, and that's my interpretation of the Viking. Sometimes the feedback is about the gear I'm using. Some are saying, well, in the Viking age they wouldn't have had a lot of iron, so they wouldn't have the kind of equipment I'm using. You have to know that the Viking age was about 300 years, and in the start they didn't have the knowledge and the know-how how to harvest iron from the ground. But later in the Iron Age, they had better materials to extract the iron from the bog and otherwise. So they had a little bit more iron in the late period of the Viking Ages. And that was the turning to the Middle Ages here in Scandinavia too. So you can't say that they didn't have a lot of iron in the Viking Age, because perhaps in the start, but in the finish of the Viking Age, they had a lot more iron they could use then. And although there have been a lot of founds from burial grounds and so on, there's still a lot of questions that are not answered, and the experts are not agreeing on all issues regarding the Viking Age. And actually they don't know as much as you would think. Most of the knowledge they have new and present are guessing. An example can be the longhouses. They have findings where they can see how the longhouses were built on the ground, but the construction in the ceiling and the roof, they don't have any knowledge about that. So the archaeologists are often guessing. They are not having the whole knowledge about how the Vikings were living. Also about the religion, the Asa belief they had. There's many questions there that are not answered. And knowledge regarding the Viking Age is growing all the way, all the time. An example I saw on the television the other day was that Vikings were not blonde or red-haired. They were also brown hair, and that because they had a lot of interaction with people down in the south. And the DNA is not white, blonde people with blue eyes, but it's also brown hair with brown eyes, like I am. So you can't say that this is a Viking and this is not a Viking. Well, I could talk about this subject for a very long time. I'm very interested in and watching all the videos and reading all the things I can about the Viking Age. I'm getting wiser every day. So if you want to know more about the Vikings, I can recommend you this channel called Skjallen. It's a Danish channel, but the man who is making those videos are talking in English. So most of you can understand what she's saying, and it's actually a very good channel. They have from the beginning about the gods and the beliefs that the Viking had, and then they are going to talk about the culture, the Viking culture, and especially in Denmark where I live. It's a Danish channel, and I think it's very interesting. So go in and check him out. I'm sure you will find some information there that you didn't know about the Vikings. So Skjallen, and Skjallen means a person that are telling stories or poetry from the old Viking Age and the Middle Age. Skjallen was a man who was telling stories, and that's why he's called that. Yeah, and I brought this little cake for my coffee. I just want to show you. I don't know if it's a special thing from Denmark. We call this a træstamme, and it's translated to a woodlock. It should look like a woodlock, and it actually does. It has marzipan on the top, and chocolates. And inside, yeah, it's difficult to explain, but it's all kind of pastry that is mixed with cocoa and so on, and rum. Tastes very nice. It's one of my favorites. And this is one of the reasons why I'm not a thin person, because I like cake. Yeah. Yeah, very talking with you, and that's not my purpose. I would like to show the surroundings here in Denmark, and hopefully we find those cozy. And a lot of you are restricted in your ways to come out because of the coronavirus. So I have a lot of comments that are saying they are glad for my videos because they bring them out in nature. When they don't have the opportunity themselves. So, the last thing I would like to talk about is my patronship. I have a lot of patrons, and I'm very grateful for all those donations they're giving me. Patreon is actually a platform where you can pay to, and then the channel or the person will give you something in return. Perhaps he can make or she can make videos especially for you, or make some giveaways or other stuff that are exclusive for Patreons. I would like to do that too, but I have a little problem here in Denmark. If I make special things for my Patreons, I have to pay taxes for the donation. If it's only donation, that will say if I only receive money, people are donating money for me, then I don't have to pay taxes. And the taxes in Denmark are very high. It's half of the money that I get will go to the government or to the state. So that's why I don't have anything special for you. And I completely understand is if some of you are disappointed about that, and after a while say, well, that's nothing for me, I want something for my money. I can understand that, and that's okay. So you have to know, if you are going to support me financially over Patreon, I'm very really grateful for that. And many of my and much of my gear I'm buying for those money. And if I didn't have Patreon, I wouldn't have I couldn't afford to buy a new camera that I have done recently, and so on. So don't misunderstand me, I'm very grateful for your support. I appreciate that very much, but as the things are now, I'm not going to give you something in return other than my love. Yeah, I love you all, especially my patrons that are supporting me financially. I appreciate that very much. But of course, all your comments, I got a lot of comments, and my latest video where I was out in the forest making my food with my new setup, my little plate, has been a very popular video, and I'm yeah, it's about 21,000 views now, and that's a lot for my videos. And it's always hard to make a video after such a success, because I know the next video will probably not be as popular as the last one. So that's yeah, that's the game. I hope you like this video, and I hope you don't think I'm talking too much. I had a lot of my mind that I would like to tell you, and I'll do that in the upcoming videos, also from my Viking trips. Yeah. Now I'm going to pack my gear down and heading home. I'm having a little, making a little project back home where I'm making a Viking lantern out of wood and then some cowhide, I think it's called. It's very interesting, and I'm going home and finish this video. I made some recordings yesterday, and I'm going to finish it now. I hope you like that when it will arrive. I'll take this lantern with me on my next adventure, my next Viking venture, so we can see what I'm talking about. Yeah. So, thank you again for watching Cimbrer Bushcraft. I really appreciate that. And I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye bye and take care.